Chikmagalur is in the foothill of Western Ghats. It's not like a hill station. It's like you're on highway, you take a detour, bang, you are in Chikmagalur. To actually get a hill station vibe, you have to climb up all those Western Ghat hills. So for the first day, we decided to take this resort, which will give you the proper feeling of a hill station. Reaching there is definitely a challenge. There are so many hairpin bends, the road is bad and narrow. You might catch a rain over there. I'll not recommend traveling at night, but once you reach there, it will be worth it. Once we reached there, we were welcomed with the temperature check, flowers and a welcome tea. Once we enter, we see a grand entrance. The very high ceiling, a very photogenic staircase. But all this open space is not the best part of this reception. The best part is the view from here. Then we had our briefing.
Coming to the restaurant, morning opens at 8 o'clock in the morning, close at 10:30. Lunch 1 to 3:30, dinner 8 to 10:30. Level 1, we have a Robusta, which is the bar. Level 0 is activity center, like PT, carambo, chess, football, table tennis, and kids play area. We have a pool, it's open at 7 to 7, but it's not a temperature control. We have a coffee shop, it's the best weapon we have in the resort. It's a 360 mountain which is covered, which will be open till 6 o'clock. 4 o'clock, we'll be connecting coffee trail walk. Walking period 45 minutes with explanation regarding the coffee plantation. Later on 7 o'clock, we'll be connecting a bonfire. So I request to join for that.
So as soon as we reached here, we rushed to buffet because we were so hungry. Because we were supposed to reach like at 12 o'clock, but we reached here like 2:30 and the buffet was about to end. And Jeannie was so cooperative that she didn't make a noise and she was just waiting like, okay, you guys just had your lunch. I'll make my noise when we reach the room. She's a ticking time bomb. She can blast any time.
In this property, wherever you go, the view follows you. The property is designed in such a way, and we enjoyed our view from the restaurant where we were having lunch. Because this is the last time when we are able to see the Western Ghats properly. Because after some time, everything was covered in clouds.
As in it is drizzling, so we have taken a jeep so that we won't get wet. My camera's getting wet. I have to go inside.
Pathway to some rooms are very steep, so it's better to ask them before coming over here that they won't provide you rooms like that. Or take their pick and drop for everything, because that's what we did.
So this is our room.
And this is the
drawing room.
So this is quite big. Big enough for a small party for 3 people. And even 6 people can do something. I don't know what, but something.
This is the bedroom.
It's a huge room. I hope you are able to hear me. Right here.
This is the biggest room I have ever stayed in my life.
This is the bed.
Soft and comfortable.
They have a lot of sitting spaces, but who want to sit in the room when you have a view like this? But if you don't like a view from the window, you have a huge balcony as well.
This is the view. This is the walk-in wardrobe. We have dumped all of our stuff here. This is the bathroom. Sink, some toiletries.
This is a shower, big enough for 4 people. And this is the toilet. I won't recommend for 4 people because I don't know how they adjust.
You might have seen the jacuzzi. But jacuzzi with a view like this is totally unexpected.
It's getting prepared. It's full of leather.
And she definitely had fun.
So how was the jacuzzi?
It was amazing. And this was in my bucket list since so long. Check.
While Nishtha was exploring the room, I decided to explore the property.
This is the pool. The view like this is breathtaking. You can just see the clouds. Actually, that which is totally covered in cloud is Mulayanagiri. It's the highest peak of Karnataka and you can see it from the pool itself. That is great. I can't tell you how much I am resisting to take a bath in this. I wanted to swim, not to take a bath in this. bath. bath. It's cold, but yeah, it would be worth it. But I can't fall in sick on first day of my 3-day trip. So let's go to next day. And this is the coffee shop. This is the Valley View coffee shop. This coffee shop totally justifies its name because it is totally covered with mountains. But the view from here is totally depends on the weather, because even with the drone, I'm not able to see either the valley or the mountains. It's totally covered in clouds. You can see it by yourself. While talking to a guide, he told me that it's a time for a trail walk. It's a great trail walk, but I'm not capable of doing that.
It's a very good trail walk over here. But I think
this Converse shoes, not a good option. So I was not able to enjoy the coffee trail, but I definitely enjoyed the viewpoint. So while I quickly rush over there, you guys can hit subscribe and click on the bell icon. Along with a great viewing room and lot of greeneries, they have other amenities as well, like pool table, foosball. But there's one amenity I was not able to enjoy because of my mistake.
Bonfire.
Actually, I am in search of bonfire. So,
one more blue.
It's down here, I think. Let's go.
So finally, I'm able to find this place.
Am I dumb to realize that because of rain, there won't be any bonfire? But still, that can be managed, right?
It was a rain, but in totally opposite direction. Nishtha engineer given me a lot of time to shoot a video. Now it's my time to return the favor. That's mostly what we did the whole night. Next morning came with their own set of challenges. We both don't know how to give a bath to a baby without a bathtub. So we improvise.
So we have one towel, another towel, and one towel for the baby.
That's how Jeannie is taking bath. I'm just thinking what I was doing yesterday and what Jeannie.
Jeannie is also taking a jacuzzi bath.
Yes.
But in her own way.
One towel. One towel. Jeannie baby!
Next day morning, and the view is not stopping to amaze me. The clouds are right here. Right here.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. So you Bill?
Yeah.
This is a coffee policy from our estate.
Okay. Thank
so
you.
So your room card.
So now we are done with the checkout. Overall, we have paid around 25,000 rupees for the room rent and 4,000 rupees for the food and everything. The breakfast was including. I think we need to go for the breakfast because we are running late.
And we finished our breakfast and move it to the next resort. We'll check that out in next video.